killed 12-year-old Damian Slayton. The suspect is a repeat offender for driving without a license. The accident happened at 71 Highway and Gregory, where KMBC 9's Bev Chapman is live right now. Bev?
Larry, police and witness reports released today say that the suspect was westbound in the eastbound lanes of Gregory until he got to this intersection. That's when he hit the concrete median in the middle. He flipped his SUV and slid on the engine hood down here where the stoplight is, ramming into the back of a car with Damian Slayton sitting in the back seat.
He was in Boy Scouts. He was a budding journalist. They said he was with the newspaper, and what he really loved doing was interviewing people.
District spokeswoman Nancy Lewis says children at Nowland Middle School, where Damian was a sixth grader, spent the day talking to counselors about the why. While police continue to figure out the how of what happened here, that's the SUV flipped upside down that started it all. Police say the driver, 30-year-old Clayton Dunlap of Kansas City, has 16 prior convictions for driving without a license. They say his clothing smelled like PCP at the scene, that he fought people at the hospital where he was taken for treatment. Today, an officer ran radar as cars sped by the spot where the crash occurred.
I'm getting high 50s, low 60s, and it's a 45, so.
Investigators are working to determine exactly how fast Dunlap was driving. Witnesses say he was driving extremely fast, weaving in and out of traffic, yelling profanities afterwards. In addition to the little boy in the back seat of his car, his mother is in the hospital in critical condition, unaware that she's lost her son.
We want the family to know that they are certainly in our thoughts and in our hearts. We know what a horrible time this has to be. It's just so, so tragic.
Back live, Damian's mother, Bree Nicely, is a first-year English teacher at Van Horn High School. Dunlap remains hospitalized with non-life-threatening injuries. We are live at 71 in Gregory. Back to you.
Bev Chapman, thank you very much. Police tonight are awaiting toxicology reports on Dunlap as part of the investigation. First alert right now at 5, a live look outside tonight. Spring is here and kite-flying weather moving into Kansas City. Checking in now with Chief Meteorologist Brian Busby. Brian, how strong could we see those winds?
Those winds could be in excess of maybe 30 or even 40 mile-per-hour gusts by midweek as we have strong high pressure over us and the strong storm which is brewing out to the west. Here are the current temperatures as we plot them on for you. 66 degrees here in Kansas City, but let's widen out and look at high temperatures, because with that warm southwest wind will come some milder air. Let me circle the 70s. 75 Dodge City, Oklahoma City, a high today of 62. That's the warmer stuff. And because our direction of the wind is in that same configuration, that's exactly what we're going to tap into come tomorrow. And it looks like we're going to stay fairly mild until the storm system gives us a chance of rain, probably by Good Friday. We'll talk more about your timeline in just a little bit. Larry, back to you.
Thanks, Brian. A firefighter suffers minor burns while battling a fire on Waldron Avenue this afternoon, rather this morning. The fire broke out just after 9 a.m. It took 30 minutes to get it under control. The house was vacant. A firefighter did suffer burns on his face. He was treated at the scene. The house is a total loss. The search continues tonight for a missing father and son from Springfield. The two were reported missing after their capsized boat was found on Stockton Lake. 36-year-old William Keese and his 8-year-old son Nathan were last seen leaving the campground on that boat. In Liberty, the school district is asking voters to approve a tax hike so they can finish the second phase of the city's new high school. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has details in a live report. Michael?
Well, Larry, 2 years ago, you might remember that the voters here in Liberty approved that new high school on the city's northwest side. Now the district is back asking its patrons for more money in the form of a tax increase so they can finish off the second phase of that new high school. The crews are hard at work on Liberty's northwest side.
This is Liberty North High School. It's the Liberty North Eagle.
Much of the school opens next year, but the district wants more money for phase two, which is a field house for sports, an auditorium, and some fine art space. Those projects, say the superintendent, have always been in the plan.
And so now we're heading towards the second phase, which was always planned for a bond in 2010.
But because of the district's budget limits and the recession, which has dropped property values, the district's main source of money, phase two must be paid for with a tax increase. The district says it amounts to $67 a year for a typical Clay County property owner.
This is on elderly people that are on fixed income. This is on small businesses that are suffering right now and barely able to make ends meet. I just think it's a bad time for a tax increase for anybody.
Porter supports building the new high school, but he thinks the district could have saved money on things like busing costs and maybe even selling off the district-owned bus fleet to pay for the $8 million required in the new high school's second phase.
Let's look and see if we can find savings first, and then if we can't find any savings, then let's take a look at a tax.
Now, there's another issue that's on the backdrop of this election vote in the Liberty School District. As you may remember, this district is now emerging from a financial scandal that involved a former superintendent. In fact, Superintendent Brewer told me today that he feels like the school district has been paying a so-called trust tax to the voters here for some time as a way to try to get rid and get past the problems from the earlier era. We're live in Liberty. Back to you.
Michael Mahoney, thank you very much. The Liberty school tax increase vote is April 6th. It needs 57% to be approved by the voters.